Hello everyone. In this video, we look at a real example on how we can implement a voting classifier using Python and sklearn. So without wasting further time, let's get started. In the first cell, basically what I've done is I've imported the necessary modules. There is this famous dataset that's readily available on sklearn called the iris dataset, which basically has 150 rows, 4 features and 1 target variable. So I load the data set into a variable called iris, and then I split iris based on x and y. I create 3 classifiers now. First is a logistic regression classifier, which is CLF1. Similarly, CLF2 is my random forest. CLF3 is my naive Bayes classifier. Okay. What I do next is I kind of check a 5-fold cross-validation score for all 3. And then when I compute a voting classifier, or when I create a voting classifier, I'll compare the accuracies of individual models against the voting classifier model. Okay. Now, when I run the cell, I find that the accuracy of my logistic regression model, which is CLF1, is 90%. Similarly, the random forest has an accuracy of 93%, and the accuracy of naive Bayes is 91%. So this is the individual level of accuracies that I have for different models. Now I create a voting classifier. Again, voting classifier is a readily available package in your sklearn library. So what you do is I import voting classifier. I specify what all classifiers I'm using to make the estimator or the whole overall voting classifier. And I specify the voting type, which can be either hard or soft, to have more understanding or a clear understanding of how your voting happens. I would insist you to watch the previous video that I've created on voting classifiers. I run the cell and I've created a hard voting based classifier out of the 3 classifiers that were there. Similarly, I make a soft voting classifier. Basically, the difference between a hard and a soft voting classifier is hard voting considers the class output and then takes the majority. Soft voting classifier takes a probability score and then averages out the probabilities. A value above a particular threshold is classified as 1. A value below a threshold of a probability score is classified as 0. Okay. I create a new list of labels based on the different classifiers that I have built. And now I compare how my voting classifier is performing with respect to the individual classifiers which are there. Okay. I run the cell and I find that my voting classifier hard and voting classifier soft both individually have an accuracy of around 95% as compared to 90, 93 and 91. So what I've done here is I've combined simple weak learners, which is basically my individual classifiers such as logistic, random forest and naive Bayes, without using any complex algorithm like a support vector machine. I could increase my accuracy just by using a simple voting technique to create a more robust and an accurate classifier. So this is the whole idea of how a voting classifier works. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.